Hey everybody, it's Phil with Behringer. How you doing today? Welcome to Music Studios. I want to talk to you today about the X-Air XR18. Now this is an 18 channel, 12 bus digital mixer for the iPad and Android tablet, and it has 16 programmable Midas mic pres, an integrated Wi-Fi module, and it's a multi-channel USB audio interface. It's got some cool features. Let's check them out. The XR18 is going to be great live and in the studio. Live, you put it on the stage by the drums perhaps, you plug in the microphones, take the outputs to powered speakers, and you're good to go for your gig. Now on the XR18, you have 18 channels of bi-directional audio via the USB port. For audiophile sound quality, there are 16 Midas mic pres, they're programmable mic pres that are built into the XR18, and you would control it with that same device, the iPad or the Android tablet. There's a built-in tri-mode router in the XR18, which makes it super simple for you to connect your device to the XR18. You can choose the Ethernet port to use an external router, you can use an existing Wi-Fi network, or there's a mode there so that you can connect directly to the router that's built into the XR18. Makes it super simple for any setup. For both corporate and for gigs, interviews happen more and more often now. There is Dugan-style auto mixing built right into the XR18, and that's going to control your gain staging, so your interviews are going to stay cool. The XR18 has the same effects as the X32. The X32 has 8 stereo effects. The XR18 has 4 stereo effects, which is going to be super strong, and you can use them anywhere in the unit where you want to. You can insert them on channels, have them as send and return, and then there's all kinds of great effects. There's reverbs, delays, choruses, all those things are there. So it's going to be super handy for you. There's a 100-band RTA built into every channel, and you can use it on the buses as well. So you'll be able to look and see how the frequencies are happening on each individual channel, and it's also great for using it on the buses, the master buses, and the aux outs, so you can EQ monitors and things like that as well. You can use the Ultranet port on the XR18 to connect the P16Ms, okay? These are great for in-ear monitor mixes, because you can send all 16 channels from the mic pres of the XR18 through the Ultranet to the P16M and dial in and EQ your own mix for your headphones. And because you can connect to these with an iPad or a tablet, an Android tablet, you can actually control your own mix, right? So you can dial it in and have it that way, or you can use the P16 to tweak as well. So what I'm going to show you is a channel strip in the XR18. So right away you can see here on the channel strip that I have a lot of great features. I have the channel input where I can choose USB, the phantom power, and then for each of these sections, the noise gate, equalizer, compressor, bus sends, and main out, there's also a tab. So I can go here and here's my input gain. Next up is a noise gate where I have some actual presets that I can use, and I can control my threshold, my attack, hold, and release time. Then I can go to the EQ section. I have different bands of EQ here, 4 different bands that I can use, and I also have a low frequency roll off. The compressor is dialed in as well with presets. Again, I can adjust all my feature sets of the compressor. On my sends here, you can see that I have my 6 buses, my 6 aux sends, and my 4 effect sends. And as you can see here, I can tap from anywhere in this single path. At the input stage, I can do a pre-EQ, post-EQ, pre-fader, post-fader, or just make it a subgroup. On the main outputs, I can go main left and right, choose, or where do I want to have it panned. And then also I have my DCA group assigns, my mute group assigns, and for the Dugan style auto mix, I can choose the channel here and the weight. I have 4 stereo effects, like I mentioned, and I have a great amount of choices for all the effects that I want to choose from limiters, guitar processors. And then finally, my last page is I have my meters. So I can always see what's going on in the XR18. So this is basically just a typical channel strip on the XR18, looking at it from the app. For those on iPads and tablets, it's going to look pretty much the same, but it's going to work great. There are rubber shoulders, rubber bumpers on the XR18, so you can literally just roll it onto the stage, plug in your mics, and go to town. In addition, there are also rack ears that come with it, so you can mount it in a rack if you want to. There are 6 auxes and a left-right bus on the XR18, and they're available for full dynamics processing. And you also have a choice of a 6-band parametric EQ or a 31-band graphic EQ per bus. The way you connect the auxes and the outputs are on XLR connectors. There's 6 of them for the aux buses. There's 2 main outs on XLR and a TRS headphone connector as well. So the 40-bit floating point DSP allows for an amazing dynamic range and near zero latency and no internal distortion. There's an app available that's great to be able to remote control the XR18. Now there is iOS and Android capable, okay, for devices. And then again, there's also a PC app, a Mac app, and an app for Linux for controlling with a computer. The MIDI in and out ports allow you to control different things and also supports Mackie control, so you can control the unit remotely using the MIDI ports. Future firmware updates and also things like effects downloads, new plugins, and things of that nature are going to be available free at Behringer.com. So this is the XR18. For more information and media, please feel free to come visit us at Behringer.com. Thanks for joining us here at Music Studios.